I was recently at my girlfriend's house and came across a couple objects that I found very interesting. They were tucked away in a closet, and I saw the cases and I thought I knew what they were, and she confirmed for me. It's some old movie equipment. First is a old Eastman camera, 8 millimeter, and a Bell and Howell projector. You can see they've been on the shelf for a while, so they've acquired the patina of dust that objects like this often do. So I thought I'd go ahead and do a little investigation. So I brought them home with me, and let's open up the cases and see what we've got. So first off, we've this latch here, and inside is a magazine Cinekodak 8 Model 90 8 millimeter movie camera. And this particular unit has a Kodak Anastigmat F1.9 13 millimeter lens. And this is all manual, of course, so it's adjustable in terms of distance. It also has variable frames per second, 16, 24, 32, or 64. It's a wind-up mechanism. And this lever is pushed down momentarily to run, or you can lock it to run continuously. It's got dial here. This is the run position, and this is the load position. And this particular unit takes film cassettes or cartridges. This particular camera was manufactured from 1940 to 1946, and it even has interchangeable lenses. Which were available at the time. And it has a dial to indicate the amount of footage left on your reel. It has a dial here to set up for exposure. Ranges from open shade to bright sun. You set your frame rate for bright sun, for example, and it tells you to adjust your aperture for somewhere between f5.5 and f8, which is done right here. So, all in all, an interesting unit. It's got your viewfinder here. It also has a dial on top. Kind of hard to see, but you adjust this dial for the particular focal length of the lens you have, and it adjusts the viewfinder accordingly internally. Interesting piece of home movie memorabilia. Also, I discovered in this case was a Zeiss Icon Icofote, Icofot, I'm not sure. Light meter. This particular unit utilizes a selenium photocell, which generates its own voltage, so the meter requires no batteries. It's basically self-powered. And as you can see, it responding to light accordingly. And it's got dials that you set up for whatever reading the meter indicates. In this case, it's showing a 4, so you would set this auto dial to a 4, where you would set the inner dial for the film speed that you were using here. And you could read off the appropriate shutter speed and f-stop along the top. It's also got a little device that you put over the photocell if you wanted to simulate reading an incident light situation, where it would appropriately cut back on the reading to compensate. So all in all, interesting little unit. This was made primarily, I believe, during the 1950s. Next up is our projector. And you can see it's been in storage for a while, and it is a Bell & Howell made in Chicago, USA. I love these old cases, the deterioration and the corrosion. It just shows the age. And this drops down accordingly. And it has its own separate power cord, of course. And the projector is removed from the case like this. And here it is in all its glory. And for all practical purposes, to me, this unit appears to be almost brand new. It's very well kept. And to be honest, I know very little about projectors, but apparently this unit was manufactured sometime during the 1940s, probably maybe even into the 50s. The bulb is right here. Here's your motor with removable brushes, should they ever wear out. It's got adjustment here for the clutch, for framing, a rewind, and a run. Your lens, of course, and your controls for your motor, and your lamp. And according to the plate, it is a Filmo Master Design 122 Model D. So I am very anxious to put some film, which I just happen to have, that came with this unit on, and get it running and see what it actually looks like. That'll follow in the subsequent video. Thank you for watching.